Hi, my name is Josh, and today we're going to take a look at the process of cleaning out a desktop computer. Basically, we're going to clean the dust and gunk that builds up inside of it. I'm going to explain how that happens, I'm going to explain why it's a problem, and how to fix it. So, without any further ado, let's get started. So, as you can see, there are these vents around the front of the computer. You'll find them on your computer, you'll find them on a laptop. You'll find them on a lot of GPS devices. A lot of electronics that can overheat rather easily will have vents on them. And the reason for that is that electronic components get damaged if they get too hot. Also, if they're really hot for an extended amount of time or just long lengths of time, that shortens their lifespan. So what they do with computers is they create an airflow system. As you can see, there are these vents around the front of the computer. As you're going to see in a second, there are fans in the back that basically push the hot air in the case, push it out. So push it out of the case. This one right here, you see this? This is where your big fat power cable plugs in, and that is what gives the computer power from the wall. So this is a unit right here, and it's got a fan, and it also pushes air out of the case. And so that creates a vacuum, so there's this emptiness, so it goes whoo, and then there's a space here to be filled. So what happens? Air gets pulled in through the vents, so cool air is getting pulled in over the components. It gets heated and pushed out. So somebody might be wondering, you know, are these holes good for ventilation? Right here. You know, if you have extra face plates for these, I recommend using them because these take away from proper airflow. And so does this. Because if more air is being allowed, you know, you're pushing the hot air out of the back. You don't want more hot air coming back in through the back. And somebody might ask, you know, why is it then that these vents are here? You know, don't they do the same thing? Not necessarily. If you have a case fan like this one and not just the PSU, the power supply unit fan, basically you have more hot air being pushed out, so that allows more cool air to be pulled in. So in that case, more vents are beneficial, just not usually in the back. And this is why they tell you, you know, with an Xbox, they tell you not to keep it in a closed cabinet, because if it's in a closed cabinet, it's pushing hot air out, yeah, but it's going to be pulling the same hot air back in through the front, and that does not allow it to keep properly cooled. And because, as you can imagine, there's lots of air flowing in and out, there's also dirt, and that dirt accumulates inside of a computer. When the dirt accumulates on top of the components, you get this layer of dust over them, the air does not do its job as well, because the dust traps the heat underneath, and that lowers the lifespan of your memory, your graphics card, your motherboard, any of your electronic components inside here that are susceptible to damage by heat. So what we're going to do today is take compressed air, or if you have an air compressor, use an air compressor to properly and safely blow out your computer without damaging the fan motors or anything else. So let's take off the case now. My case is actually pretty easy to come off. There's actually a screw hole in the back which might hold it on. Somebody might have removed the screw, so there might not be a screw you have to look for. You can also see this little loop right here. Sometimes people put a lock on it or a zip tie in order to keep anybody from pulling it off. But in my case, you just pull like that. Then you lift up, and simple enough, right? So, you know, there's lots of different makes, models of computers, and they're all open differently. Some use latches, some use a button, some use just a slide-off case with a screw holding it on. So, you know, Acer, Toshiba, Gateway, whatever it is, go to their support site. So Google Dell support, or Toshiba support, or HP support, and look up your model number under their support website. If you look under their new computers part, you know, the sales part, you're not going to find it when you search for it. So make sure you're searching in the right area. So search for your model number and look for a disassembly guide or some instructions on how to open up your computer, how to replace things. And usually it'll tell you the proper way to do it. You should not have to bend anything or break anything in order to get into your computer. Just keep that in mind because, you know, I learned that the hard way a long time ago.
So as you can see, right here there's a heat sink, and that is what covers the Southbridge chip of the computer. And it's basically, it's just like this one, but it has a heat sink. And what the heat sink does is it takes all the heat off the chip and puts it onto these little fins. And then the air blows through the fins, and because there's multiple fins, it has more surface area, so it cools more efficiently. And as you can see right here, these are also heat sink fins. It's another heat sink, and this fan actually pulls the heat off of it, off the processor, and up, and then this pushes it out of the case. And as you can see also here, the RAM gets kind of dirty, and the hotter the RAM gets, the shorter its lifespan is going to be.
So as we've already covered, there are fans inside the case. We are going to blow out the case using compressed air. If you do that, it's going to spin the blades of the fan. If you spin it too fast, you're going to burn out the motor, which is bad because next time you turn on your computer, the fan's not going to spin up because the motor is burned out, and then you're actually going to burn out the components on your board, which will damage your computer. And so you want to make sure you get all the dirt out so that there's no dirt keeping the blades from spinning at all next time, and you want to keep them from spinning while you're blowing it out. So what we do, easy little trick, take a screwdriver or something that'll fit in between the blades and put it in there. So as you can see, it's not gonna spin, and you stick another one in there like so, bam. Okay, so we're gonna use compressed air. If you have a compressor, great. If not, just use some compressed air, like in a can. Try to get the stuff that's made for electronics, as there is also non-electronics purposed air, and that can actually damage your electronics if you spray it on the wrong thing. So that's about it. Blow all the dust out of your case. Make sure all the connectors are back where they were before, if you unplugged anything by accident. And yeah, just clean out your computer once in a while. It's good for the computer, makes it live longer, and keeps it running coolly and efficiently. Coolly. And that is about it. So if you want more videos like this, subscribe to my channel, and thanks for watching.